I've been creating content for multiple platforms and clients for a while now, and I know that if you don't have a great system to churn out different types of posts and ideas, it all crumbles super fast. If you're struggling with keeping up with posting for social media or staying consistent, you need to watch this video. Let's do this. Hi, my lovely friends, it's Natalia, and welcome back to my channel where I share super actionable ideas on content creation for entrepreneurs and creatives. And today I'm coming to you with a subject I feel is not talked about enough, and that's content creation process. You see, I believe in order to stay consistent, you need three things: a well thought out strategy, a database of ideas, and a system to plan and schedule content. It's honestly like a tripod, and without one of the legs, this whole thing crumbles pretty fast. And the third leg, the system that I'm focusing on today. To make sure you're as efficient as possible, you need to build a process to research, produce, and publish your content. And I'm going to explain exactly what my process looks like, so hopefully you'll get inspired and improve your workflow. In this video, each step is going to have two parts. First, I'll explain what my general workflow is, which applies to each and every piece of content I create. And then I'll explain how this translates specifically to one of the platforms I'm personally creating for, which is, well, YouTube. Each type of content will have a slightly different mode of operation, but all creation ultimately follows these general steps. The tool which I use to manage my content creation process, and frankly, most of my business operations, is Notion, so you'll see specifically how I use it and what it looks like for me. And of course, I want to give credit where credit is due. My process was inspired by two amazing creators, Ali Abdal and Thomas Frank. Thomas's process is very elaborate and complex, and I was completely blown away by how much you can actually do with Notion after watching his video. And then I watched Ali's video, which simplified things a bit for me, and I worked off his template to build a similar workflow for my own YouTube production journey. It has since changed and developed in different ways because, you know, as with anything, it's very important to make it work for yourself and how you operate. Nevertheless, both these videos were a huge inspiration to me, and I'll link them for you down in the description box, so go ahead and check them out too. Step number one, research. The first thing I do is to research new content topics in line with my overall content marketing strategy. A strong strategy is always the foundation of a great business, and let's face it, the foundations always need to be solid, so if you don't have a strategy yet, definitely watch this video and download my free workbook, which helps you build an effective strategy yourself. Once that's done, I know exactly what types of content I need to create in order to serve my perfect audience. So the idea research stage is literally about checking what they currently are searching for, what problems they have which I can solve, and identifying any other topics that may interest them. So with the example of my YouTube workspace in Notion, I use a Kanban board style or Trello style, whatever you may call it. And I choose this view style for many other parts of my content marketing, like blog posts, newsletters, and I have a slightly modified systems for other social media platforms. So basically it represents all the steps that each video needs to go through, which means I have a clear path and everything's neatly organized instead of being all over the place. And having this system means I don't ever go, you know, shoot, what do I do next? Or I never scramble for ideas as well. So speaking of ideas, all of my ideas land in this column in here. And anytime I have an idea or one of my viewers requests a video and asks a question which I can, you know, expand on in a video, I create a new page for it here. And for each new video, I have a template which has all the necessary components and actually serves as a checklist for this whole process I'm explaining today. But I'll go through it with each step. So again, this template is based off of Ali's original template, and you can download it in his video. And I've linked mine down below as well if you'd like to use this one that we're working on here. So it popped up at the top of this column in here. And when I'm ready to produce a video from my ideas list, I just move it to the going ahead section. And this is where all my planned videos enter the pipeline. So once I start researching for a particular video, I can move it to the research and outline stage, which takes me to step two. Step number two, outline. Now that I have pinpointed a topic and have a general idea of what I'm creating about, I do research specifically for this video and outline this piece of content. And whether it's long form content like a blog post or a YouTube video or something shorter like an Instagram post, it doesn't really matter. I still list key messages I want to convey. This helps me arrange them in the correct order to form a clear path or a logical conclusion. And not only does it facilitate the rest of the process for me, but it also makes sure that my audience gets exactly what they need. So back in Notion, I want to explain a little bit more on how I use templates, and that comes into play already in step two. So I can click on the video here and we can start off with naming it. So let's say I was making a video on how I plan and execute content for a month. So next, as you can see, we've got this section in here, which shows you all the different details about a video. And you can see the status, which represents the column in the board view. And usually at this point, I'll have a rough estimate on the publish date, which I can enter in the box in here. So next we've got the genre and intention, and this categorization helps me search for previous videos quickly and see how I can mix up different types of content on my channel. And there's a wee checkbox to tick when I consider a piece of content my cornerstone content. It's kind of a highly valuable piece, usually evergreen, containing tons of knowledge and, you know, radiating into other videos. So I also have this other content mention section, which basically links to the same database, this YouTube database, and I can just type in anything and this pulls all the different pages I have within it. And I use it to track any mentions that I had throughout videos, and it's particularly helpful for me when I'm teasing an upcoming video, which I can just add on here as well. And I also include any resources that I share in my video here, which links to another database, and I named it Our Resources, and it contains any freebies, any affiliate links, any workbooks, ebooks, basically any resource that I share with you guys, I enter it here as well. It means that I can link them back easily to each video and I never forget to include the links in the description box. And trust me, I learned the hard way, by the way, so it's a great option that Notion allows you not only to, you know, create a database with so many different variables, but also connect multiple databases and they all get updated when I update one part. So scrolling down, I have my main page section here, which again pulled all the pre-formatted sections from my template, and I can start researching for this video and start creating an outline. So this is my inspiration section where I can put any videos or posts that I found very useful to mention them later, and it's a toggle list, so it just hides away and doesn't create too much bulk. I like keeping things out of the way and hidden so it's more minimalistic. And here I have resources, so various websites and tools I use to research. Then the research section where I basically type in anything that comes to mind. So it's sort of a brainstorm section. So for example, when I was creating my top 20 Canva tips video, I had like 60 different tips in here and I pulled the best ones below into my outline. I also have a wee to-do list here in case I need to do anything while creating. So for the same Canva video, I needed to create a few designs before to show the tips. And I have this as a task in here. Coming down, I have a place to brainstorm different title ideas and a section to enter my tags. I usually have a few crucial keywords identified beforehand so I can sprinkle it across my script. There's the thumbnail idea section to come up with what it may look like, so I have pointers when I'm designing. And then there's the script part, so I have another toggle list with different storytelling resources. Ali explained some of the ones that he had in his video, and I do write with these principles in mind, so I go through it, but I'll skip it for now. Then I have a basic structure of my script, so the hook, which is basically the video's value proposition. I usually share quickly how the viewer is going to benefit from watching it and try to capture attention from the get-go. Next, there's the intro section where I introduce myself and explain in more detail what the video is about and introduce the subject. And then we have the value section, which is, you know, the meat of the video, so to speak. So this is where I outline my video drawing from my research section. I write each main point and have a few bullet points of what I'm intending to say for each of those. And then once it's outlined, I'll see whether it's creating a logical, cohesive kind of train of thought. And if I don't feel like it all falls perfectly into place, I play around with it a bit and change the order. Step number three, create. And on to the execution, which is of course the creation itself. Here's where I write my post, caption or script, where I take photos or choose relevant images, design graphics or record a video. And the workflow will look a bit different depending on the type of content you're creating, but it still follows the steps I'm laying out in this video. So say if I'm producing a post for Instagram, I'll research the subject, outline it, then flesh out a full caption, choose a photo because I usually plan photo shoots beforehand, or take one more spontaneously and then edit it. I put it all together as a finished piece of content, but that doesn't mean that my content creation process ends here. So for YouTube videos, this creation step has a few different points, of course, because after I've got my outline, I need to write a full script, film the video, and edit it before I can obviously confidently say it's been created. And again, this is represented in the Kanban view with further columns. So I have the writing in progress section for when I'm writing the script. And once that's done, I move the card to the ready to film A-roll section. When it's recorded, it goes to the ready to film B-roll, obviously if it's needed for this video. And when everything's recorded, this goes to filmed and then can get picked up and moved to the editing section. Step number four, check. Next, I make sure there are no mistakes, typos, weird unaligned elements in my design, or any missing CTAs in my Instagram post or a YouTube video. And at this stage, I also check if I quoted all the relevant sources or credited other creators who inspired me. So for YouTube videos, I obviously have a few checkpoints. So when I write a script, I'll review it, checking for these types of mistakes, and then I'll watch the video when it's edited to see if there aren't any glitches or any uncut footage, which I omitted by mistake while editing. And it all gets done just before I move it to the next section, so I never move anything over to edited unless it's been checked. Step five, ensure it fits the strategy. Now, I know I mentioned strategy at the very beginning, and that's absolutely right. I start with a strategy, but it doesn't end there. I specifically included this step in my workflow to make sure that each piece of content I produce fits the strategy. And the reason for this is simple. Very often you come up with an idea for content and it works fine with your goals, but once you actually get down to work, get in that kind of creative space, what you produce may not always be what you intended at the very beginning. And this happens especially often when you work within teams and everyone can interpret ideas differently. And that's why for me, it's crucial to always check this finished piece of content is good to go and checks all the boxes laid out in the strategy. So if a piece of content doesn't represent your brand values, if it's a post format that didn't resonate with your audience in the past, or it goes against your goal, it shouldn't be approved. So again, for YouTube, this step takes place after I've written my full script. So this way, I know I've not strayed too far from the purpose of this video or the overall goals of my content marketing. And I make sure that my brand values are being represented well and it resonates with my target audience. And if I feel like it's not really up to par, I go back and change the script to make sure it all fits the strategy. Step six, optimize. Now that I've given myself a green light to go ahead, I focus on optimizing this piece for the platform it's going to be published on. This means improving and optimizing for SEO and choosing a mixture of relevant, high-ranking keywords, tags, or hashtags. And moreover, I'm making sure all the images are in the right format, have the correct dimensions and optimum size, and have alt text and description, or I'm writing down an alt text for an image I'm posting on Instagram, etc. So in Notion, when the video is edited, I change the status to ready for publication, and this is when I think about optimization. So I have a checklist in my template below the script, so I work off this to-do list here. And I upload the video to YouTube, add a description, I expand on the tag list, I design the thumbnail using one of the templates I've created already, so it's a quick and easy process. And then I add end screens, cards, choose playlists, and add captions. Step seven, publish. When everything is optimized, I'm ready to publish my piece of content or schedule it for later. And depending on the platform I'm using, there are multiple tools that let me schedule content ahead of time. And those are either the tools available natively on Facebook, Pinterest, or WordPress, or I use external scheduling apps like Later or Hootsuite when I cannot really schedule directly from the platform. And for YouTube, after uploading and optimizing the video, I can just schedule it from there and I tick my to-do task on the video and move it to the published section. Step eight, distribute. Once my content is published, I go ahead and distribute it through my chosen channels of communication. And whether it's posting on Instagram story to let my followers know I have a new blog post, uploading a snippet of my YouTube video on IGTV, or tweeting it, I have to make sure that I'm doing all I can to actively promote the content I've just produced. And many people actually forget about this part a bit and simply rely on the algorithms to recommend their content. But the more proactive you are with this, the better. And after all, if you can get more people interested in your content with your action, it accelerates the growth and gives you better results in the end. So this step is also reflected in my workflow in Notion, and you can see it here to the left. And again, it's a simple to-do list. So I can tick these and that's done. Step 9, plan further marketing activities. So this is the last step of my content creation process. First, I fill in all the remaining details in my content directory, which is basically my Notion workspace. You'll see it in a moment. And then I make sure to respond to any comments or emails and engage with my audience or other creators. And on top of that, I set reminders or tasks to post evergreen content after a particular time. And it's usually kind of 3 months, half a year, and a year from the time it was published. And for any new content that may need updates from time to time, I schedule dates to review it. And this way I may produce an updated version of a popular blog post or produce another video after a year to include the newest information. And of course, I remember to check back regularly and look at my analytics as well. So if a particular piece of content performs well, I will repurpose it for other platforms or expand on the subject. So right after publishing, I update the details in the video with the URL, which is useful if I ever need to link back to it. So I just search in Notion instead of scrolling through my videos on YouTube to find the right one, of course. And the engagement to-do list is down here in the right column. So I tick these once I'm done, and any other marketing activities get planned specifically in the content calendar. If you'd like me to share how I manage this portion in Notion, let me know in the comment section down below. If you'd like to learn more about strategy, social media, and content marketing, check out this playlist next. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video, and hopefully it will help you create content more efficiently. Hit that like button if you found it helpful. It helps my channel grow as well, so I really, really, really appreciate it. Subscribe for more content creation tips, and I'll see you next time.